Welcome to Southside Christian Preschool 2013-14 graduation. We would like to take a moment and thank some of the people who make this preschool rock. We want to thank the parents, grandparents, families, and the church congregation for investing time in our kids and the preschool as a whole. We also want to thank Ms. Tanya, Ms. Kathy, and Ms. Sharon for subbing for us this year when it was needed. And another huge thank you to Pastor Becky, Ms. Susie, Liz Meeker, and our board members, Sue, Sharon, Kathy, Chuck, and Pine. All of these people that I've mentioned have truly invested a lot of love, time, money, and are the definition of a team, and we couldn't do this without any of you guys. Now for some of the stories of the year. This year, Mrs. B had something in her class that we like to call Cameronisms. These are sayings that just would come out of the blue that would make our hearts smile, and I'll just tell you a few of them. One of them was, "I never get bored. I love school. It's my favorite." And I think he's been watching the movie Elf. Then y'all, during playtime, he's like, "Focus, focus," on his boys, I guess. Another time he's saying, "Hey, I think I'm getting the hang of this," while he was writing his last name. "Big fat belly, down the hill, this is easy." That's a capital R. Big fat belly down the hill. "I'm on a roll, everything is an eight." That's because it was a number eight worksheet. "I hear the music of running." That's because my class was in the gym before their class was. Then today, this one actually came out of Lucy. She brought in this black pencil, and if you rubbed on it, it turned pink. I said, "Oh my gosh, Lucy, that's my favorite color. I love that." She goes, "Well, I got it at kindergarten roundup." I said, "Oh, you've got to give me one of those." And she goes, "Hey, I'm already rounded up for kindergarten." So, and then another saying that came from my class this year was, "Oh, chicken feathers," every time he was mad. But you have to do it growling. That's very important. We like the fun stories, so I'll give you just a couple more. One of my little girls says, "Miss Mary, Noah has pennies." I say, "Well, that's awesome." She says, "And Trey has pennies, and Chris has pennies." Noah says, "Miss Mary, do you have any pennies?" So I say, "Yeah, I have some nickels and some dimes, too." My little girl says, "Miss Mary, you don't have pennies, you're a girl." Turns out she's right, I don't have pennies. Then there was the day that one of my precious little treasures really got me. I was working at the table with one of my kids when the other kids started screaming frog. So, my classroom is somewhat in the basement. It's possible you can get a frog down there. So I took a glance down, and I said, "Don't touch it!" And so I went flying up the stairs, and Miss Sharon was here, who just happened to be here. And all I said was, "Miss Sharon, frog!" Because I don't do things that are slimy and move. So she came running down because everyone knows that I'm not a fan of these things. So after getting her a cup and a plate to catch it, it came to my attention by Miss Sharon that it was a plastic frog. Then my sweet little treasure Samantha goes, "Gotcha!" So, moral of the story, I'm blind, all my kids know this, and it don't like frogs. So there was never a dull moment going on this. And lastly, the kids are going to sing a song from a Bible verse that they learned for you tonight. It's from Joshua 1:9. It's called, "Have I not commanded you, be strong and courageous? Do not be terrified, do not be discouraged, for the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go." The way these kids sing this song is absolutely breathtaking. It's what we want them to remember and take with them as they leave us and grow up to be strong Christian kids. But we want it for all of you too, and even myself and Mrs. B, to remember. God is with us all wherever we go, and no matter what life throws at us, we're not going to be discouraged, but we're to be strong and courageous. We believe it, and we know that you will too, especially after you hear our kids tell it to you. This group of kids has been incredible this year, and we've loved getting to be a part of their lives, and we just want to thank you so much for sharing them with us. So I'm going to go get them.
Thank you. for chat.
You know, really, you don't get much cuter than that, do you? These kids are pretty cute. And as our teachers are leaving, I want to say a special thank you to Ms. Mary and Mrs. D for all that they do for our children. Not just in the brief window that they have them, but the lessons that they teach and the love they share with each of our kids. Carries on to them forever. And so they really are such a blessing to all of us. For all that they do for our children. So thank you, Mrs. B and Ms. Mary. Let's have a word of prayer, and then we will follow that with an offering, and your donations for the offering will go toward the preschool today. Let us pray. God, we thank you for this beautiful day in which the children, the innocence that they share, and love and the joy that just bursts forth from them. We just can't help but carry ourselves. So we thank you for teaching us through the kids. And as they've gone through a wonderful year of preschool here, we are grateful for the foundation that you have laid in them through parents, families, and friends, and these teachers, and this congregation, to carry them forward into kindergarten and grade school and beyond with a firm foundation of faith and education. We ask your blessings upon each of the students as they get ready for kindergarten and for all the things that they have yet to explore. We pray your blessings in the name of Christ Jesus. Amen. As you receive the offering, you'll see some thank you pictures of our little kiddos throughout the year, so please enjoy. Thank you.
Avery Wilson Smith.